Welcome back to my channel Math School. In today's video, let us solve example 15 from chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry. In my previous videos, I have completed examples 1 to 14 and exercises 11.1 to 11.3 from the same chapter. If you have not watched these videos, do find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. And also watch the video till the end so that I can make more such videos for you guys. Now quickly, let us begin with the video. Example 15 from chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry says, prove that sine theta minus cos theta plus 1 divided by sine theta plus cos theta minus 1 is equal to 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. And this we have to prove using the identity secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. So this question is very much important and it is a bit tough question. It is better you practice this whole problem to solve this problem easily. So here let us consider the left hand side part and we will prove this left hand side part equal to this right hand side part. So write down the left hand side is equal to sine theta minus cos theta plus 1 divided by sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. Since we have to use the identity secant square is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, we know that tan theta is equal to sine theta divided by cos theta. So therefore, we will divide here the numerator and denominator by cos theta so that we will get the value in numerator and denominator as tan theta. Okay, so write down, divide numerator and the denominator by cos theta. Okay, so dividing, the first term is sine theta divided by cos theta minus, again we have cos theta divided by cos theta plus 1 divided by cos theta. Okay, so again this is the numerator part. Now let us do the same procedure in the denominator. So it is sine theta divided by cos theta plus cos theta divided by cos theta minus 1 by cos theta. Right, so this will become what? Sine by cos is tan theta minus this cos and cos will get cancelled and we will be left with minus 1 plus 1 by cos theta, the whole divided by again sine by cos is tan theta plus again cos and cos will get cancelled. So plus 1 minus 1 by cos theta. So what is the value of 1 by cos? 1 by cos theta is nothing but equal to secant theta. So this is how we can obtain the tan and secant value in the numerator and denominator. So we will substitute 1 by cos equal to secant theta again. Okay, so we know that 1 by cos theta is equal to secant theta. So therefore we can write tan theta minus 1 plus secant theta divided by tan theta plus 1 minus 1 by cos is again secant theta. Now let us rearrange the terms here and write it as tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 divided by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. Okay, now the very important step here is, now since we have to bring on the right hand side secant theta minus tan theta, so let us multiply the numerator and denominator by tan theta minus secant theta. So write down, multiply the numerator and denominator by tan theta minus secant theta. This is very important step, students. So please practice this whole problem again and again. In the numerator, what do we have here? It is tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 divided by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. And now we have to multiply and divide by tan theta minus secant theta, the whole divided by tan theta minus secant theta. Okay, so here in the numerator, first we will multiply tan theta plus secant theta into tan theta minus secant theta. Now you can observe that this tan theta plus secant theta and tan theta minus secant theta are in the form of a plus b into a minus b, which is equal to what? A square minus b square form. So therefore we will write in this identity form, that is tan theta plus secant theta into tan theta minus secant theta will be tan square theta minus secant square theta. So directly we am writing here, that is tan square theta minus secant square theta. Then now again multiplying this with the minus sign, so this will be minus into tan theta minus secant theta, the whole divided by, the denominator will be as it is, that is tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 into tan theta minus secant theta. So here, since they have asked us to use the identity secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, so we will use that identity here. Now here what they have given us, that secant square theta is 1 plus tan square theta. Okay, so since we want tan square theta minus secant square theta, so we will send the secant square to right hand side and bring this 1 to left hand side. So this plus 1 will become minus 1, equal to this plus secant square theta will become minus secant square theta, that is tan square theta minus secant square theta. So instead of tan square theta minus secant square theta, we are going to write this minus 1 by using the identity which they have given us, right? So tan square theta minus secant square theta is equal to minus 1. Then again we have a minus sign here. Let us open the bracket now. Minus into tan theta will be minus tan theta, then minus into minus will become plus secant theta. Okay, so this divided by, again we have here tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 into tan theta minus secant theta. Now here you can observe that in the numerator we have minus 1 and the denominator we have plus 1, whereas the tan sign is minus in the numerator and the denominator it is plus, and again similarly the secant sign is plus and in denominator it is minus. So let us take out this minus sign here common, so that the sign in the numerator and denominator becomes same and therefore we can cancel out the terms. So when we take this minus sign in common in the numerator, this minus 1 will become plus 1, minus tan theta will become plus tan theta, and plus secant theta will become minus secant theta, right? And in the denominator also we have what? We have plus 1, then we have plus tan theta and minus secant theta. I'm rearranging the terms in the denominator so that we can cancel out easily. So here we have tan theta and minus secant theta. So therefore you can cancel out 1 plus tan theta minus secant theta in the numerator and denominator as well. So we will be left with minus 1 divided by tan theta minus secant theta. But here in the right hand side you can see that the denominator we have is secant theta minus tan theta. So therefore again here we will take the minus sign common in the denominator. So we will have minus 1 divided by, when you take minus sign out as common, you will get plus secant theta and minus tan theta, right? So this minus and plus in the numerator and denominator will cancel out and you will be left with 1 divided by secant theta minus tan theta, right? So we have proved here that the left hand side is equal to right hand side. This is how we solve this problem. If you have any further doubts, you can comment me below in the comment section, and also do practice this whole problem again and again so that it will be easier for you to solve in your examinations. In my next video, I'll be solving question number 1 from exercise 11.4, chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry. So till then, do like my video, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos, as I'll be completing the whole syllabus for class 10th SLC and cert math. And also do watch the related videos of chapter 11, introduction to trigonometry, shown on the screen. Thank you.